Hello everyone. Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très content aujourd'hui d'être accompagné par la vice-première ministre Freeland et les ministres Lametti, Mendicino et Blair. On est ici aujourd'hui pour faire le point sur les occupations et les barrages illégaux et sur la loi sur les mesures d'urgence. On Monday of last week, after days of dangerous and unlawful activities in our capital city and at many border crossings across the country, the federal government invoked the Emergencies Act. It was the responsible and necessary thing to do. We did it with three principles top of mind. First, restoring peace and order. Second, doing it the right way. And third, making sure that it was time limited. The first point. Restoring peace and order in our streets and restoring confidence in our institutions was top of mind. Public safety, as well as jobs and the economy, were at risk. People were being harassed, small businesses were closing, factories were shutting down, and trade was halted at our borders. Here in Ottawa and in other places in the country, there is evidence of individuals wanting to undermine and even harm Canada's democracy. Their participation was believed to increase the potential for unrest and violence. We worked closely to support provinces and municipalities to get the situation under control. But as the weeks went by, it became obvious that provincial and local authorities needed more tools in order to enforce the law and protect Canadians. And that's exactly what the Emergencies Act provided to them. Lundi de la semaine dernière, le gouvernement fédéral a invoqué la loi sur les mesures d'urgence parce que les autorités locales et provinciales avaient besoin de plus d'outils pour protéger les Canadiens. Comme le chef intérimaire Bell du service de police d'Ottawa l'a dit, la loi sur les mesures d'urgence a été un point tournant pour mettre fin à l'occupation illégale. Maintenant, l'ordre est rétabli et les barrages et les occupations sont terminés. Second, when we invoked the act, we needed to make sure we did it the right way. We'll always defend the rights of Canadians to peaceful assembly and to freedom of expression. As I said before, the Emergencies Act was created to flow from and uphold the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms. These measures had to be, and were, compliant with the Charter. Parliamentarians debated, and the House voted. We followed procedure, and it is critical that we continue to do so. That's why a joint committee of parliamentarians will be struck to review the declaration of emergency. Within 60 days, there will be an inquiry into the circumstances that led to the Emergencies Act being invoked. It will look at how we got there and why it was required. It could look at policing. The inquiry could also examine the funding, influence, and disinformation that supported the illegal blockades and occupations, both foreign and domestic. D'ici 60 jours, une enquête sera déclenchée sur les circonstances ayant mené à l'invocation de la loi sur les mesures d'urgence. Elle pourrait porter aussi sur les activités policières. De plus, l'enquête pourrait permettre d'examiner le financement, l'influence et la désinformation qui ont soutenu les occupations et barrages illégaux, que ce soit en provenance d'ici ou de l'extérieur du pays. And finally, our third principle. We were very clear that the use of the Emergencies Act would be limited in time. When we invoked it, it would be in place for up to 30 days, but we said that we would lift it as soon as possible. We've held updates and briefs with ministers and officials every day, often multiple times a day. And today, after careful consideration, we're ready to confirm that the situation is no longer an emergency. Therefore, the federal government will be ending the use of the Emergencies Act. We are confident that existing laws and bylaws are now sufficient to keep people safe. Of course, we'll continue to be there to support provincial and local authorities if and when needed. And I want to reassure Canadians. Law enforcement agencies are prepared to deal with anyone engaging in unlawful or dangerous activities. Police officers will continue to be there to protect our streets and neighborhoods within their jurisdictions. Aujourd'hui, après avoir soigneusement examiné la situation, on constate qu'on n'est plus en situation d'urgence. C'est pourquoi le gouvernement fédéral met fin à la loi sur les mesures d'urgence. On juge maintenant que les lois en place sont suffisantes pour assurer la sécurité de la population. Évidemment, on va continuer de soutenir les autorités locales et provinciales aux besoins. Je veux rassurer les Canadiens. Les autorités sont prêtes à intervenir auprès de toute personne qui prendrait part à des activités illégales et dangereuses. Dans le respect de leurs compétences, les policiers vont continuer de protéger nos rues, nos quartiers, notre pays. Going forward, it'll be important that we gain a fuller understanding of what gave rise to this kind of disregard for laws and threat to our democracy. We need to make sure our institutions are prepared and ready in the future. While the immediate emergency situation is over, this issue won't just go away. We need to constantly work to defend and improve our democracy at home and around the world. Il est important que nos institutions soient prêtes à l'avenir et qu'on poursuive notre travail pour défendre et améliorer notre démocratie. Canadians have been through a lot, and we have a lot of challenges ahead of us. Let's remember that we're fighting a virus, not each other. Let's work together. After two difficult and painful years, we have a lot of healing to do. And now is the time to be there for one another. Merci.